Paint Chevrolet in Springfield. 9 decades, 3 generations, 1 tradition.
I got what I asked for at Paint Chevrolet. That's the honest truth.
And for me, as the director of Parks and Rec, thank you for what you've done. I know for Gina and Ryan, I speak the same, and for the whole city, actually. You've done a great job. You did really, really well. Thank you for that very much.
I know a lot of people love this place. Terry didn't know what he was in for when I first asked him if we could have a dog park. When he said they just needed somebody to raise the money, he didn't know that I was that somebody and it was really going to happen.
I do now.
I've been harassing him for years. I know he just looks forward to my emails. But mostly I just want to thank the people that started in the very beginning. And we didn't even know we were going to have a park, and the people that bought the t-shirts and did the bake sales and things like that, and they got us recognized. And then historic event coordinators came in and they took us to where we are now. And now you're gonna take us to the original park that we first visioned, and we're actually gonna have some stuff for the dogs to do and a water fountain. And thank you very much.
That's right.
Thank you.
Amen.
Well, thanks guys. I just wanted to say congratulations to the city of Springfield. This is a contest. People compete for it. There were 60 cities all over the state that competed, big cities like Nashville that didn't win, but places like Springfield that did. And the way you win is by showing how much passion you have for your park, how much dedication, how much engagement, the social media, the letters. Springfield really represented. My wife and I have traveled all over the state, and we've been to a lot of communities. We love Springfield. We've been here many times before. You love your downtown and everything about it. So if we were just picking favorite towns, we'd have probably picked Springfield. But I just want to let you know we didn't cheat. You actually won this fair and square. We're happy to be able to present to you today a $25,000 grant. And this is something that Jenny and I, my wife and I, started 2 years ago. Our company makes the Invisible Fence and PetSafe and other brands of pet products. And the people that buy those products that love their pets helped us be successful. So we just thought, you know, let's give back to the people that have given so much to us. And we love our state, so this seemed like a natural way of doing it. You already will know this, but I think you'll see it even more with the improvements that you're going to make to the park. The parks are not just for dogs, but they're for people too. And one of the things I've noticed, and I'm sure all of you have as well, is there is a lot of divisiveness in the world. People are torn apart by so many different things. We need more things that bring people together, and dog parks do it. We've seen dog parks all across the state. We'll go visit, and you'll see people on a park bench that normally just wouldn't be hanging out together. You'll see young people and old people sitting on a park bench watching their dogs play. You'll see rich people and poor people sitting on the same park bench. Sometimes, not very often, but sometimes you'll actually see on the same park bench a Republican and a Democrat sitting on the same park bench. It can happen. So dog parks, I think, are great for our pets, they're great for our communities, but they're also great for the people in the community as well. And so we're just proud to be able to offer this to Springfield, and just want to say congratulations to everybody for this award.
Thank you. With that,
we're going to give you a big check.
Yes. And then we can do some photos of in front of the step and repeat. If you guys
those showed up late.
I like to go ha ha ha, ha ha ha. I like to go hee hee hee, hee hee hee. We have a lot of fun, my mouth and me.
I like to go.
Dig City Dining in Springfield. Depot Bar and Grill.